Hi, I'm Dr. James Machino. What causes memory loss and how do you prevent it? Well, what causes memory loss? There's three types of dementia you can develop in your lifetime. There's classical Alzheimer's disease, where you lose the memory chemical and beta amyloid plaque builds up and strangles the nerve cells. And on the inside of the nerves, you build up these neurofibrillary tangles, which is a very serious problem, of course. There's also vascular dementia, where you clog your arteries up, usually through poor dietary and lifestyle behaviors, and now blood and oxygen and nutrients can't get to certain parts of the brain because you've clogged the arteries in your brain. Then there's a mixed kind of dementia, where it's sort of a combination of Alzheimer's and the vascular form that we were talking about. So those are the most common ways that you end up with memory loss as you get older. There's some things that can lead to memory loss. Parkinson's disease, there's a memory loss component. A vitamin B12 deficiency can lead to memory loss. And of course, just clogging up your arteries can do it. As we said, head injuries, of course, are a common cause with people that have had a lot of head injuries from sports or accidents. And the other thing to know is that after the age of 55, the brain has trouble making the optimal amount of the brain chemical called acetylcholine that leads to some cognitive impairment in almost all of us, even if we don't get Alzheimer's disease. But there are some dietary and lifestyle things you can do to maintain those levels of acetylcholine, which I'm going to share with you. But Alzheimer's memory loss is particularly devastating because Alzheimer's disease is a type of dementia that really is usually terminal. And even though the progression of the disease varies from person to person, you know, usually, you know, within 7 years, on average, the person's life has come to an end as a result of it. The early stages of Alzheimer's disease, what to look for, short-term memory loss, difficulty attaining new information, and then you see decreased abstract thinking and planning abilities and being able to manage one's life as effectively as they once did. It's called loss of executive planning. And then often in the early stages, a decline in motor skills, like handwriting ability starts to decline. That's quite noticeable. Or being able to, you know, dress oneself. With progression, the classic signs, confusion, disorientation, mood changes, irritability, aggression, trouble with language. Then, of course, long-term memory loss sets in. You stop recognizing even family members, and this is where it becomes really heartbreaking, of course. And gradually, bodily functions start to shut down, and usually it leads to the person's demise. How common is the problem? Alzheimer's disease is the sixth leading cause of death in this part of the world. One in eight people over the age of 65 have Alzheimer's disease. Nearly 50%, at least 45% of people over the age of 85 have Alzheimer's disease at some level. Of those with Alzheimer's disease, only 4% are under the age of 65. About 6% are between 65 and 74. Then there's a huge jump from 74 to 85. 45% of people have Alzheimer's disease. People over the age of 85, another 45% of those people have Alzheimer's disease. But in people over the age of 65, 10 to 20% already have what's called mild cognitive impairment. They're already losing some of their faculties, even to a mild level. On a macroscopic look at the brain in Alzheimer's disease, you see nerve cells are dying. Parts of the brain are shrinking. Nerve transmission, electrical impulses are being shut down at what are called the synapse sites. So you get a shrinking of really key brain areas that's visible even on a CAT scan or MRI. On a microscopic level, it's very fascinating. The nerve cells themselves are unable to make optimal amounts of the memory chemical called acetylcholine, so memory drops off. But then you get a buildup of this weird protein plaque outside the nerve cells that's really strangling them, called the beta amyloid plaque. And certain parts of the nerve cell architecture inside breaks down, and things coalesce together, forming what's called neurofibrillary tangles. More recently, we've seen that people with high blood sugar levels, diabetics, people who are overweight, who have insulin resistance, where there's higher blood sugar levels, higher insulin levels, develop what's called type 3 diabetes. They start sugarcoating things in the brain, and you see these products like dolichyl phosphate, which indicate that you're getting sugar-coated materials in the brain, also leading to dementia and Alzheimer's disease. So this is a huge risk. But only 1 to 2% of people that get Alzheimer's disease, is there a strong genetic inheritance. So aging and lifestyle factors really are the most important things. Now, other causes of memory loss include Parkinson's disease, vitamin B12 deficiency, vascular dementias, head injuries. And as I said, just as you get older, the brain can't make enough of the memory chemical called acetylcholine, especially after the age of 55. But we'll deal with how you can manage that. My problem is that the medical treatment for Alzheimer's disease and these more advanced dementias is to give people drugs that slow down the breakdown of the memory chemical. That's really all they have to offer. But it doesn't address the other things that are going on in the condition, and so eventually the drugs fail. By the time you give the person the drugs, it's often too late to really make a substantial difference. I will tell you that all the evidence points to the fact that if people will put into place a comprehensive lifestyle program while their brains are still reasonably healthy, that the chance of having these brain changes decreases dramatically, and the chance you're going to have a healthier brain as you get older increase significantly. So the comprehensive program that you should be putting into place is to have the right diet, the diet that's not going to clog up your arteries in your brain as you get older, and how to decrease inflammation in the brain as well. And you need supplements at a certain stage that will maintain the levels of the brain chemical called acetylcholine. I'll talk a little bit more about that. The other thing is that 20% of the oxygen in the body is used by the brain. And oxygen has a negative effect in one sense, that it generates free radicals that sort of causes corrosive effects on the brain, causes the brain to rust. And these free radicals are an intimate part, or an integral part, of Alzheimer's disease and even conditions like Parkinson's disease. So you need antioxidants have been shown to slow down the process of brain damage. And you need nutrients that are going to preserve the transmission of impulses through the brain. And you have to know how to slow the shrinking of the brain. Certain nutrients have been proven to do that. There are no drugs that can slow the atrophy of the brain after the age of 55 or 60. But there are nutrients that can do it. And there are supplements that have been shown experimentally to stop the buildup of amyloid plaque. And there are also lifestyle things, mental and physical activities that maintain the nerve circuitry so that the brain doesn't age and you maintain your faculties much better. So it's not just waiting to get Alzheimer's disease and taking a drug that's going to cure you. That's not happening, and it's not happening anytime soon. You need a lifestyle program. That's where the solid evidence is. The problem is that most medical doctors don't study these lifestyle and natural interventions in medical school or even in continuing education programs. They're not emphasized enough. So what I've done is I've explained it all in a little e-booklet that's available right here. It's called The Nutritional Guide to the Prevention of Memory Loss and Alzheimer's Disease. I can tell you every single person should download that book, read the information, you'll see all the scientific references, so you know I'm not making this up. It's not being pulled out of the sky. This is where the evidence is strongest to preserve your brain throughout your lifetime so that you can decrease the likelihood that these memory loss problems and Alzheimer's disease are going to catch up with you at some point down the road. So please download it right now. Now, at machinohealth.com, you'll see my other review articles and other videos that I've created, some videos from my live professional seminars, other resources, downloads I've created. They're all there to help you lead a long, healthy, functional life. My review papers and all my teaching materials are complete with all the scientific references, so you know you're getting only sound scientific evidence from me on any health condition that you're looking for. So you really should make machinohealth.com an ongoing, reliable resource for health and wellness information for both you and your family members. Thanks so much for watching.